Carcinoma of the colon and rectum, which is called colorectal carcinoma. The incidence of colorectal carcinoma, as all GIT malignancies, usually occur in male above 50 years. But it should be noticed that rectal carcinoma exceptionally may occur in young age, may occur in young age around 30 year in some cases. Carcinoma of cecum and right colon also has exception in sex. Carcinoma of cecum and ascending colon slightly much more common in female. What is the predisposing factor of carcinoma of the cecum? The most important predisposing factor in carcinoma of cecum is genetic. The genetic factors related to all the following predisposing factors. First of all, it is said that genetic changes may occur in the normal mucosa. Genetic mutation once occur in the normal mucosa, leading to dysplasia. And dysplasia develops to villous adenoma. And sooner or later, villous adenoma progress to carcinoma. Also, genetic factor appear if there is colorectal carcinoma in the first degree relatives. Familial blobosis, we all know that this disease is genetic. Autosomal dominant disease. Familial bulbosis, the risk factor in this disease, in familial bulbosis, is 100%. Large villous adenomas, large more than 2 centimeters. Very, very high risk to become malignant in 100%. Therefore, familial bulbosis, which is genetic disease, is very important predisposing factor, especially in large villous adenoma, more than 2 centimeters. A type of familial bulbosis is called Gardner's syndrome. This is a type of familial bulbosis coli associated with bullae in the whole GIT and associated with stioma in the mandible and the skull and associated with desmoid tumor in the anterior abdominal wall. Benign tumor in the colon or rectum is precancerous, especially as we said before, villous adenoma. Therefore, all these factors, genetic predisposing factor, predisposed to villous adenoma. And villous adenoma may be familial bulbosis and the Gardner syndrome, and first degree relatives. All these related to the genetic factors. Also, genetic factor play an important role in obesity, which predispose to type 2 diabetes. It is said that obesity and type 2 diabetes are risk factor of colorectal carcinoma. Ulcerative colitis, inflammatory bowel disease, Ulcerative colitis is pre-cancerous condition because the chronic ulceration leading to chronic irritation of the mucosa ending by malignancy. Also, smoking and alcohol are pre-cancerous. It is said that smoking leading to chemical carcinogens, which are pre-cancerous to the colon and rectum. Bad habits in the diet, dietary factor, is very important. It is said that low fibers diet with high animal protein and high animal fat diet breed cancers. Why? It is said that animal fat and animal protein in the colon, the bacterial flora acting on this excessive fat and the protein with release of chemical carcinogens. Finally, this operation is breast cancer. If there is a carcinoma of the renal bladder, the treatment is radical cystectomy, including removal of the renal bladder. And the following removal of the renal bladder, this operation, which is called urine diversion, implantation of ureter into the colon, which is called the uretrocolic implantation. The mucosa of the rectum and sigmoid colon now exposed to urine. And it's said that continuous exposure of mucosa of sigmoid colon and rectum to urine is chronic irritation ending by malignancy. Therefore, the most important predisposing factors in colorectal carcinoma mainly genetic, plus smoking, alcohol, ulcerative colitis, chemical carcinogens, bad dietary habits, and this operation, which is called uretrocolic implantation. What is the pathology of colorectal carcinoma? This is before the pathology. This is a classical drawing for the predisposing factor of colorectal carcinoma. Familial bullosus, villus adenoma, ulcerative colitis, chemical carcinogens, dietary factors. Beside all the genetic factors we mentioned, pathology. What is the site of colorectal carcinoma? The site of colorectal carcinoma, about two-thirds of cases at least. Here, this is the sigmoid colon, and this rectum. Sigmoid colon and rectum represent at least about two-thirds of cases of colorectal carcinoma. We all know that the colon consists of appendix, cecum, ascending colon, right colic flexure, transverse colon, left colic flexure, descending colon. This S-shaped is sigmoid colon and rectum. Also, the colon, including the rectum and the anal canal. About two-thirds of cases in sigmoid colon and rectum. And About at least 10% of cases occur in the cecum and ascending colon. The cecum and ascending colon are called right colon. About 5% of cases are multicentric tumor. There may be carcinoma of right colon, carcinoma of transverse colon, carcinoma of sigmoid colon in the same time. These are called multifocal or multicentric tumors. What is the gross picture of this is a famous picture for the most important predisposing factor, which is villous adenoma. And in familial bulbosis, this is a dangerous adenoma which transformed to malignancy, villous adenoma, which is characterized by, on the surface, there are cylindrical villi, multiple cylindrical villi, therefore it is called villous adenoma. Grossly, as any GIT tumor, the malignancy may be proliferative type in the form of fungating irregular ill-defined mass with areas of hemorrhage, necrosis, and degeneration, or ulcerative type. Malignant ulcer with the elevated everted edge and the necrotic floor. And these two types, proliferative type and ulcerative type, as in all GIT, usually occur in the wide areas of the GIT, like fundus of stomach, body of stomach, or the wide area of the colon. The wide area of the colon is cecum and ascending colon. Therefore, the commonest pathological type on the cecum and the ascending colon is proliferative type or ulcerative type. The third routine type in the GIT is annular structure type. Annular structure type, which produces stenosis in the lumen of the GIT, leading to rapid obstruction. And we said before that malignancies in the GIT, like a devil, want to produce maximum rapid harm for the patient. Therefore, always stenotic type occur in narrow area of the GIT as esophagus or sigmoid colon and upper part of rectum. Sigmoid colon and upper part of rectum are narrow area. And if structure type occur, leading to rapid obstruction of the gut, rapid intestinal obstruction leading to maximum harm for the patient and the early death. Therefore, annular structure type is very, very common in the left colon, especially sigmoid colon and the upper rectum. The lower rectum is white, called the ampulla of the rectum. The lower side of the rectum is called the ampulla of the rectum and white. Because it is white, what is the commonest pathological type here? These two types. Fungating cauliflower mass or malignant ulcer occur in the lower third of the rectum, which is called the ampulla of the rectum. There is a rare highly malignant type, which is called mucoid or colloid type, in which the wall of the colon is infiltrated by gelatinous, malignant, irregular, ill-defined mass. This is called mucoid or colloid type. Microscopically. Microscopically, what is the type of malignancy in colorectal carcinoma? At least 95% of cases are adenocarcinoma, because the malignancy in the colon and rectum arise from columnar epithelium. And we know all that any tumor arises from columnar epithelium, usually adenocarcinoma. 95%. Where is the remaining 5%? The remaining 5% is squamous cell carcinoma. How squamous cell carcinoma occur in the colon? It does not occur in the colon. It occurs in the lower part of the rectum, which may occur as metaplasia, chronic irritation by carcinogenic material, maybe. But why squamous cell carcinoma in the lower part of the rectum, which beside the anal canal? And you all know that the lower half of the anal canal is lined by stratified squamous epithelium. Therefore, squamous cell carcinoma in the lower part of the rectum may spread from the lower half of the anal canal. The upper half of the anal canal, like the rectum, lined by columnar epithelium. But the source of squamous epithelium here is the lower half of the anal canal. Therefore, squamous cell carcinoma, which may occur in 5% of colorectal carcinoma, may occur in the lower part of the rectum due to squamous metaplasia or spread from the lower half of the anal canal. As all GIT tumor, the adenocarcinoma may take one of the following forms. Columnar cell adenocarcinoma first, which is the commonest, in which malignant cells are arranged incomplete and incomplete irregular acini. Or in columnar cell carcinoma, excessive mucus secretion may occur, leading to excessive mucus secretion in the lumen of the acini and inside the cells and in the tissue spaces. And in this case, with excessive mucus, it is called mucoid or colloid type. And you all know, in any carcinoma called mucoid or colloid type, this is a cell with accumulation of excessive mucus in the cell, leading to pushing of the nucleus to the periphery. Cell with nucleus in the periphery becomes like signet ring appearance. In Arabic, زي الخاتم السوليتير بتاع الخطوبة إن شاء الله تلبسوه كلكم. There is another type called spheroidal cell adenocarcinoma, in which variable masses of spheroidal cells are separated by variable amount of fibrous tissue stroma. This is the microscopic picture of colorectal carcinoma, most probably adenocarcinoma, either columnar cell adenocarcinoma or spheroidal or mucoid type or spheroidal cell carcinoma and colloid carcinoma. Rarely squamous cell carcinoma in the lower part of the rectum. What is the T&M staging of colorectal carcinoma? As T&M staging we meet before in GIT malignancies. The standard staging here is TNM staging. T is a primary tumor. N is the lymph node metastases. M, distal metastases. T, as all primary tumor in the GIT, T is zero. TIS. TIS is tumor localized to the mucosa above the basement membrane. TIS. Tumor localized to the mucous membrane. T1. If tumor invade the lamina propria or muscularis mucosa or submucosa, it is called T1. If the tumor invades the muscle layer, the muscularis propria, this is called T2. If the tumor invades the subserosa, T3. Tumor invades the serosa and the surrounding structure is called T4. N, node metastases. If there is no lymph node metastases, this is called the N0. Enlargement of lymph nodes from 1 to 3 lymph nodes. N1. Enlargement of 4 or more lymph nodes. RN2. Distal metastases M, either M0, no distal metastases, or M1, there is distal metastases. This is a pathology of colorectal carcinoma.